Spring. At Mount Washington's Raven Lodge on Vancouver Island is the doorway to Strathcona Park. It is a place filled with alpine meadows, old growth forests, lakes, caves, glaciers, and rugged mountain peaks teeming with life. Spring is also a time for rebuilding. There is no off-season for a Nordic skier, and base training begins in earnest with the snow not yet melted. At high altitude, the sun is warm and the air thin. Long, slow distance hikes in the mountains and ski striding with poles emphasize cardiovascular endurance, an essential attribute for a cross-country skier. At the top of Mount Albert Edward, you can see straight down 7,000 feet to the Pacific Ocean and contemplate the 20-mile return journey to the lodge before sunset. It is the perfect time to sit back, take off your shoes, and enjoy a snack. We catch up with Olympic skier Justin Wadsworth at Smith Rock, near his home in Bend, Oregon, and speed to a secret high-altitude training site, known only to Justin and his partner, Olympic medalist Becky Scott. Justin Wadsworth is arguably the best skier on the continent. He brings a refreshing style and panache to the sport that flows from the heart. Going to visit Justin Wadsworth and Becky Scott at their home in Bend is somewhat like taking an ecotourism trip to Jurassic Park, where the local wildlife has home advantage. The Cascades are often referred to as the American Alps, with a chain of spectacular volcanic peaks, rugged summits, snowfields, alpine meadows, immense fir, cedar, and hemlock trees. If you pay attention, you may see wild mustang, cougar, deer, or elk along trails used by the Shoshone Indians or an occasional skier. The mountains above Bend, Oregon, collect one of the deepest snowpacks in the world. It is where the cool Pacific Northwest spring weather keeps the snow on the ground well into summer. Bend is the outdoor recreational capital of the U.S. Pacific Northwest, with 300 days of sunshine a year. It is located on the eastern leeward side of the Cascade Mountain Range and along the Deschutes River. The town sits on the desert dry valley floor, below a line of impressive volcanic peaks. Now, it is not uncommon for Justin to summit three 10,000-foot mountain peaks in a day on cross-country race skis. A member of the Canadian national team and proud resident of Bend, Becky Scott continues to dominate sprint ski racing on the planet. Justin and Becky are skiing in their element, across huge snow bowls amongst the volcanic peaks of Broken Top and the Three Sisters. Certainly one of the most spectacular sights imaginable in perfect conditions. Justin and Becky are dedicated 24 hours a day athletes who practice skiing as a religion.
The thing that makes cross-country skiing really unique and really great is it's the hardest physical activity I think there is. It's the toughest sport. I mean, you're involving every muscle in your whole body pretty much, and you're always, when you're racing, you're always right on the edge of you know, of going totally anaerobic, but you have to be pushing the envelope the whole time, otherwise you're going to be dropping off the back. And when you're on top of your game in cross country skiing, you know, when you've peaked and you've mastered it all, you feel almost superhuman, that you could, you know, you just look at a 10,000 foot mountain and you know you can just run up it no problem. And that's a pretty incredible feeling. It's totally, you know, no boundaries. You can go anywhere you want, over anything you want, cover as much distance as you want. I mean, it's total freedom. To ski it, and when you're in good shape, it's just, it's magic. It feels really good, and you know that there's a reward once you get up there of this just totally open playground with jumps and bumps and berms and half pipes and anything you want. It's right at your hands, and you can just go for it. It's what cross-country skiing is all about. I love it. I mean, the bottom line is I love skiing.
Most, or if not all, of my best experiences in cross-country skiing have come with the team and just being around our group. We often get picked out on the World Cup for the team that's having the most fun. I do always enjoy skiing. I wouldn't be doing it for this long or as long as I have done it if I didn't really enjoy it.
The days are getting longer, and the same sun's rays that reflect off glaciers stream into forests, furnishing the energy needed by all living things. Aerobic athletes feed off of the enriched surroundings. Summer will soon be here. And with it comes a diversity of clean, oxygen-fed sports.